Let's discuss GST on supplies through e-commerce episode number 2 on the YouTube channel of Taxheal.com. Let's first study TCS by e-commerce operator flowchart. First, we have to decide whether supply is through e-commerce operator. If yes, then we have to decide whether consideration for taxable supply is collected by e-commerce operator under Section 52 of CGST Act. If answer is no, that is the consideration is not collected for taxable supply by e-commerce operator, then no TCS is to be deducted from the payment of supplier to be made by e-commerce operator. Here, it has to be noted that Section 52 has not yet been notified as on 11th of September 2017. If the consideration for taxable supply is collected by e-commerce operator, then we have to ask a second question, whether the services has been notified under Section 95 of CGST Act and 55 of IGST Act, that is the services that have been supplied by the supplier through e-commerce operator are notified under Section 95 or 55 of IGST Act. If answer is yes, then no TCS is to be deducted from the payment of the supplier. However, if answer is no, then TCS to be deducted from the net value of taxable supplies of the supplier at the rate not exceeding 1%, which is to be notified by the GST Council. तो हम लोग इस स्लाइड को एक नटशेल में समझ लेते हैं, यानी कि यदि ई कॉमर्स ऑपरेटर के थ्रू हम कोई सप्लाई कर रहे हैं और उसका कंसीडरेशन ई कॉमर्स ऑपरेटर कलेक्ट करता है, मान लीजिए अमेज़न के थ्रू हम लोग कोई सर्विस दे रहे हैं और उसका कंसीडरेशन अमेज़न कलेक्ट करता है, उसके बाद सप्लायर को पे करता है, तो हमें यह देखना कि क्या वो सर्विस नोटिफाइड है अंडर सेक्शन 95 और 55 ऑफ IGST एक्ट। यदि यस, तो उस पर TCS की प्रोविज़न अप्लाई नहीं होंगी, यानी कि जो ई कॉमर्स ऑपरेटर है बिना TCS काटे जो है वो सप्लायर को पेमेंट करेगा, लेकिन यदि वो सर्विस नोटिफाइड नहीं है तो उस पर TCS की लाइबिलिटी बन जाएगी और वह जो TCS है वह ई कॉमर्स ऑपरेटर को सप्लायर को पेमेंट करने से पहले काटना होगा। यहाँ पे यह ध्यान देने वाली बात है कि यहाँ पे जो वर्ड है वो सर्विसेज नोटिफाई की गई है 95 और 55 के अंदर। यदि कोई सप्लायर गुड्स को सप्लाई कर रहा है थ्रू ई कॉमर्स ऑपरेटर, तो उसके ऊपर जो TCS की लाइबिलिटी है वह बन जाएगी और ई कॉमर्स ऑपरेटर को सप्लायर ऑफ गुड्स जो है उसकी पेमेंट करने से पहले उसके ऊपर TCS काटना होगा। यहाँ पे यह भी ध्यान रखने वाली बात है कि सेक्शन 52 जो है वो अभी तक नोटिफाई नहीं किया गया है, Let's study about TCS process under GST. First of all, TDS will be TCS will be collected by the e-commerce operator. Then he will deposit the TCS to the government. Then he will file the GST return. Then the supplier can check how much TCS has been collected by the e-commerce operator, and he can claim this TCS in his GST return. Now let's see when e-commerce operator required to collect TCS. He is required to collect when consideration is collected, that is in the month in which he collect the consideration from the party, he is required to collect TCS. Whether he makes the payment to the supplier or not, it is not relevant. If the consideration is collected, then in that month itself he has to collect TCS from the payment of the supplier of goods or services which are made through e-commerce operator. Then he has to deposit this TCS within 10 days after the end of the month in which the amount was so collected. Then he has to file GSTR 8 within 10 days after the end of the month, that is he has to file GST return. Then the supplier can check his TCS in GSTR 2A, because once the e-commerce operator files the GST return, then it will be reflected into the return of the supplier in the format GSTR 2A, and he can claim this TCS in GSTR 2, that is the supplier can claim TCS in GSTR 2. Here it has to be noted that the supplier दैट इज द ई कॉमर्स ऑपरेटर इज ऑल्सो रिक्वायर्ड टू फाइल द एनुअल रिटर्न इन GST 9B एंड इट हैज़ टू बी नोटेड दैट द सप्लायर कैन क्लेम TCS इन GST 2 एंड द अमाउंट विल बी क्रेडिटेड इन टू द इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कैश लेजर ऑफ द सप्लायर. लेट्स डिस्कस FAQs. हु इज रिक्वायर्ड टू कलेक्ट TCS? इज एवरी ई कॉमर्स ऑपरेटर रिक्वायर्ड टू कलेक्ट TCS ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द एक्चुअल सप्लायर? आंसर इज येस. एवरी ई कॉमर्स ऑपरेटर अदर देन एन ऑपरेटर रिक्वायर्ड टू पे टैक्स अंडर सेक्शन 9(5) ऑफ द CGST एक्ट 2017 और 5(5) ऑफ द IGST एक्ट इज रिक्वायर्ड टू कलेक्ट टैक्स वेयर कंसिडरेशन विद रिस्पेक्ट टू अ टैक्सेबल सप्लाई इज कलेक्टेड बाय सच ई कॉमर्स ऑपरेटर. रेफर सेक्शन 52(1) ऑफ द CGST एक्ट 2017. हु इज रिक्वायर्ड टू कलेक्ट TCS? Do travel agents providing services through digital or electronic platform qualify as e-commerce operators? Will they be required to collect tax at source as per the provision of section 52 of the CGST Act 2017? Answer: Online travel agents providing services through digital or electronic platform will fall under the category of ECOs liable to deduct TCS under section 52 of the CGST Act 2017. Who is required to collect TCS? I am a supplier selling my own products through a website hosted by me. Do I fall under the definition of an electronic commerce operator? Am I required to collect TCS on such supplies? As per the definition in section 244 and section 245 of the CGST Act 2017, you will come under the definition of an electronic commerce operator. However, according to section 52 of the Act, IBID, TCS is required to be collected on the net value of taxable supplies made through it by the other suppliers, where the consideration is to be collected by the ECOs, e-commerce operators. In case where someone is selling their own products through a website, there is no requirement to collect tax at source as per the provision of this section. These transactions will be liable to GST at the prevailing rates. Who is required to collect TCS? We purchase goods from different vendors and are selling them on our website under our own billing. Is TCS required to be collected on such supplies? Answer is no. According to Section 52 of the CGST Act 2017, TCS is required to be collected on the net value of taxable supplies made through it by other suppliers, where the consideration is to be collected by the e-commerce operators. In this case, there are two transactions where you purchase the goods from the vendors and where you sell it through your website. For the first transaction, GST is leviable and will need to be paid to your vendor on which the credit is available for you. The second transaction is a supply on your own account and not by other suppliers, and there is no requirement to collect tax at source. The transaction will attract GST at the prevailing rates. TCS if supply not taxable. There are sellers who are selling exempted or zero tax goods like books through e-commerce operators. Will marketplaces be required to collect TCS on such supplies? Answer: As per section 52 subsection 1 of the CGST Act 2017, TCS is to be collected on the net value of taxable supplies made through an e-commerce operator. When the supply itself is not taxable, the question of TCS does not arise. TCS liability if supplies through two or more e-commerce operator. There are transactions in which two or more e-commerce operators are involved. In such cases, who should deduct the TCS? Answer: In such cases, each transaction needs to be treated separately and examined according to the provision of section 52 of the CGST Act 2017. The TCS will be deducted accordingly. Penalty if TCS not collected. In case the e-commerce operator fails to collect the tax under section 52 subsection 1 or कलेक्ट एन अमाउंट विच इज लेस देन द अमाउंट रिक्वायर्ड टू बी कलेक्टेड अंडर द सेट सबसेक्शन और वेयर ही फेल्स टू पे टू द गवर्नमेंट द अमाउंट कलेक्टेड एज टैक्स अंडर सेक्शन 52 सबसेक्शन 3 ऑफ द CGST एक्ट ही शैल बी लाइबल टू पेनल्टी अंडर क्लोज 6th ऑफ सबसेक्शन 1 ऑफ सेक्शन 122 ऑफ द CGST एक्ट दैट इज रूपी 10,000 और द अमाउंट ऑफ TCS इन्वॉल्व्ड विच एवर इज हायर. When TCS should be collected? What time should the e-commerce operator make such collection? Answer: The e-commerce operator should make the collection during the month in which the consideration amount is collected from the recipient. Refer Section 51, Subsection 1 of the CGST Act 2017. Value for TCS. Question: There are the cases in which the e-commerce operator does not provide invoicing solution to the seller. In such cases, invoice is generated by the seller and received by the buyer without e-commerce operator getting to know about it. The payment flows through the e-commerce operator. In such cases, on what value is TCS to be collected? Can TCS be collected on the entire value of the transaction? Answer: Section 52, Subsection 1 of the CGST Act 2017 mandates that TCS to be collected on the net value of such supplies. Net taxable value of such supplies, in respect of which the e-commerce operator collects the consideration. The amount collected should be duly reported in GSTR 8 and remitted to the government. Any such amount collected will be available to the concerned supplier as credit in his electronic cash ledger. Net value of taxable supplies means the aggregate value of taxable supplies of goods or services or both other than the services on which the entire tax is payable by the e-commerce operator made during any month by all registered persons through such operator reduced by the aggregate value of taxable supplies return to the supplier during the said month as per explanation 52(1) of the CGST Act 2017. Remittance of TCS to the government. What is the time within which such TCS is to be remitted by the e-commerce operator to the government? The amount collected by the operator is to pay to the government within 10 days after the end of the month in which the amount so collected. Refer Section 52(3) of the CGST Act 2017. Statement of TCS. Question: Is the e-commerce operator required to submit any statement? What are the details that are required to be submitted in the statement? Answer: Yes, every e-commerce operator is required to furnish a statement electronically containing the details of outward supplies of goods or services affected through it, including the supplies of goods or services returned through it, and the amount collected by it as TCS during a month within 10 days after the end of such month. Refer Section 52(4) and Section 52(5) of the CGST Act 2017. The statement will be filed in form GSTR 8. The detail furnished by the operator under Rule 67(1) of CGST rules shall be made available electronically to each of the supplier in Part C of form GSTR 2A on the common portal after the due date of filing of form GSTR 8 as per Rule 61(1) of CGST and SGST Rule 2017. Statement of TCS, that is the annual return. The operator is also required to file an annual statement in form by 31st day of December following the end of the financial year in which the tax was collected in GSTR 9B as per Rule 80, sub Rule 2 of CGST and SGST Rule 2017. Statement of TCS rectification. The statement can be rectified by the e-commerce operator. He is required to pay tax with interest in such case. However, such rectification is not possible After due date of furnishing a statement for the month of September following the end of the financial year or the actual date of furnishing relevant annual statement, whichever is earlier as per section 52(6) of the CGST Act. No certificate for TCS issue. The provisions relating to tax collection at source and thereby depositing the same with the government by electronic commerce operator are provided in section 52 of the CGST Act. However, provision regarding issue of certificate for payment of taxes so collected at source appear to be missing. Thus, the TCS that is when the e-commerce operator collect the TCS, then he will not issue any certificate to the supplier of goods or services whose TCS he has collected. Only it will appear in his GSTR 2A, where to show supplies through e-commerce operator in GST return. Is it required to submit the detail of supplies affected through e-commerce? Yes, the return provides for the declaration of the details of all taxable supplies affected through e-commerce along with GSTN of the e-commerce portal in GSTR 1. However, this would be implemented once the relevant provision of GST law are notified. How should exempt supplies through e-commerce operator be reported in GSTR 1? It should be reported in a consolidated manner in the enumerated and exempt supply section of the GSTR 1. Claim of TCS. How can actual supplier claim credit of this TCS? The amount of TCS paid by the e-commerce operator to the government will be reflected in the GSTR 2 of the actual registered supplier on whose account such collection has been made on the basis of the statement filed by the e-commerce operator. The same can be used at the time of discharge of tax liability in respect of the supplies made by the actual supplier. Refer section 52(7) of the CGST Act 2017. Watch next episode on the e-commerce under GST, in which we will discuss about the return filing process in case of e-commerce. Latest and best books on GST, and for reference material, click on the link given in this YouTube video description. Subscribe to my YouTube channel for GST update, like it and share it. Regularly visit taxheal.com for GST updates. Thank you.